Hello, I'm Ethan Burks. Early this morning, the U.S. government proceeded with the first federal execution since 2003. 47-year-old Daniel Lewis Lee died by lethal injection at the federal prison in Terre Haute. Lee's execution went on despite objection from the victim's family and various religious organizations who protested against his death. Lee was convicted in 1999 of killing an Arkansas family and a plot to build a whites-only nation in the Pacific Northwest. In his last moments, Lee still claimed his innocence. Two more executions are scheduled for later on this week. Christy Bennett has decided to waive her initial court hearing scheduled for Friday. Bennett is the woman who drove her red Toyota through a line of protesters during last Monday's rally against racism in downtown Bloomington. Bennett was released from the Monroe County Jail last week after posting a $500 cash bond. Bloomington police impounded Bennett's car, processed it for evidence, and released it to her after fees were paid. A pretrial conference is scheduled for September 14th. And Indiana football players are now back on campus for summer workouts.
At this point, all the players that are on campus have all been tested. So we have 120 players right now that are on campus. All of our coaches have been tested.
IU says four student athletes out of the entire athletic department have tested positive for COVID-19 since testing began on June 8th. That's out of nearly 300 tests that were given out. Last week, the Big Ten announced teams will only compete against conference opponents. The Hoosiers football team is scheduled to open its season on the road at Wisconsin on September 4th. And for weather tonight, we're looking at a low of 66 degrees with mostly clear skies, winds at 5 miles per hour. And then tomorrow, things warm up as we see temperatures rise into the low 90s and the sun comes out before thunderstorms coming Thursday, Friday, and into the weekend. For more news, you can go to WTIUnews.org. Be sure to tune in Fridays at 6 for Indiana News Desk. Have a great evening, everybody.